Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Prabhupada Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Agyanti Mirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Shri Chaitanya Mano Vishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeyam Shri Guru Shri Yutaha Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitamscha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Aschatide Shatarine Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabho Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. So I'm grateful to all. Grateful to all the devotees for their continued enthusiasm in hearing about the glories of the holy name. We were discussing this morning from Srila Prabhupada's quotations on the holy name, this book called Chanting Hare Krishna. And today is the last session, or tomorrow morning also there will be one more session. So we have these two more sessions. And today I would like to discuss one particular section where Prabhupada is explaining the importance of how to chant actually. What is the real mood of chanting and how one should try to develop the chant with concentration. So this was in one lecture in Durban, Africa in October 1975, and Prabhupada explaining that when we are chanting Hare Krishna, this is a practical way of teaching how to think of Krishna all the time. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, always think of me, become my devotee. Man mana bhava mad bhakto. The same thing is told by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by saying, chant Hare Krishna always, kirtaniya sada hari. Because chanting Hare Krishna means thinking of Krishna. So Prabhupada writes here that we are teaching devotees how to think of Krishna all the time. Satatam kirtayantoma. By chanting Hare Krishna, we are thinking of Krishna. And Prabhupada explained that we chant on a bead. We should chant the whole mantra on the bead very attentively. Sometimes, you know, when we are in ecstasy, we may take two or three beads together. It's a very I mean, you may feel that this is for very new devotees, but a very so-called senior devotee like myself also sometimes make this mistake in ecstasy. And you may find, oh, my rounds got done in 4 minutes, something, special mercy. You have to be very careful. The Bhurijan Prabhu, next time I come, I would like to discuss from Bhurijan Prabhu's book also. The Bhurijan Prabhu very much elaborates that how one mantra at a time, the mind should hear the mantra. As we are chanting, so we should hear. Synchronization. Like when there is data transmission, the sender and the receiver have to be synchronized, the speeds have to be matched. Otherwise, there will be loss of data. Correct? Or the electronics engineers know this fact. So we have to synchronize our mind with the data, the holy name which is being transmitted. One thing we should also know is compared to other material data, this Hare Krishna mantra is actually descending from the spiritual world. It is not a material sound vibration. Golokera Premadhana Harinama Sankirtana. This Harinam Sankirtan is actually adventing from Goloka Vrindavan. So when we are chanting, we should know this is something very valuable. You know how material world people like to get imported things, especially electronic items imported from United States, sometimes from Japan. Most of the time they come from China actually, but they are packed, made in US. But this is imported from the spiritual world. Now this one verse, Golokera Premadhana Harinama Sankirtana Ratina Janmilo Kenatai. This is a verse spoken by Narottam Das Thakur, that this Hare Krishna Mahamantra is descending from Goloka Vrindavan. It is avatar. Avatar means that which descends. Just like the Supreme Lord descends, the holy name also descends. The difference is the Supreme Lord, not everybody can perceive him. The holy name is available for everyone without qualification also. The only thing necessary is the sincerity. We should be sincere and serious to chant the holy name. So once Srila Prabhupada was explaining, going on a morning walk, and the disciples of Prabhupada told that Prabhupada, some of the scientists in the United States, they did an experiment. Did an experiment towards the higher planets. You know, they sent some signals. Just like nowadays they're trying to send Chandra and, you know, something, the moon, and some disaster taking place since attempts. So much money they could give for book distribution. And Prasadam could make our temple ready in 1% of that money, less than 1%. With the 1% money we could build 10 temples. Anyway, even if you go to the moon, what is the big deal? What will you do there? Eating, sleeping, mating, defending, you know. In moon also, suppose as people start going, there are political parties there also, you know. Moon, that part of the moon where US went, that part of the moon where India went, you know, it will, first of all, you can't go to the moon, we know from Shastra, because actually going to the moon means you have to have a visa. Suppose even if I go to United States without a visa, I'll be thrown back, sent back, free ticket back to India. So you can't go to the moon with the present body. But anyway, so this scientist, they were doing some research and they were sending some signals, you know, like previously they have Morse code, some signals like that, they were, and they sent some signals from the higher planets and they got a reply. Can you believe what the reply was? The reply was, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram. It's a true story. It's in morning walk, one scientist, they were doing this research, and when Prabhupada heard this, he said, see, I told you, Golokera Premadhana Harina. That is Hare Krishna mantra is coming for higher planets. And then the US government or whichever was responsible, they said to scrap this project. Because they thought, if this project, if they get the news that Hare Krishna mantra is coming, then it's going to become so popular. And people will not get cheated in our so-called science. So they had to, and it's very, I mean, those of you who have done research, you know, it's not everything that is given is actually true, and many of the truths are hidden also. The truth is not spoken, and what is spoken is not the truth. Some truth is there just to cover up. Otherwise, science is like, just like I did research for 2 years. In research, what you have to do is just find out what other people have done and find out their mistakes and just polish it a little bit, and that's new theory. So research means you have not searched, re-research. We don't have to do any research. Bhagavad Gita is there, Bhagavat is there. You will not find anybody, you know, I found actually Bhagavad Gita has got 20 chapters. And, you know, Krishna is not a supreme lord. There's another person who just overtook Krishna, you know. Our philosophy is already fixed. The scientists, they keep on scratching there because they have to do something. They are getting so much funds from the defense, government defense department, millions of dollars. So they have to show something. That take the same paper, usko aise thoda idhar aake namak mein dal ke. That's a paper. So anyway, if any of you are scientists, please forgive me for my being very honest with you. But I was also like this. You know, this is part of the game. If you do PhD, you have to do like this. So anyway, so the fact is that this Hare Krishna mantra is actually coming from spiritual world. When I am chanting Hare Krishna, I am not in this material world. I am, to the degree my consciousness is absorbed in the holy name, to that degree I am with Krishna. That should be our mood. Like today morning, some of our devotees chanted. Did you chant extra rounds, some of the devotees? Till 12 o'clock? Till 1 o'clock? 2 o'clock? 1 o'clock. How many devotees were there? How many were there totally? And?
4-5 devotees were there.
And others were there. Higher planets. Yeah, the seva is also. And of course, there were 6. Jagannath Balasubhadra, Gornitai, Panchatatra, about 12 people are here. But tomorrow we'll again make an attempt to chant more after the Sunday feast is over. I had to rush because there's a commitment and I'll be surprised to. I'm not comparing, but the Bhakti Center, some 40-45 devotees chant. They started at 8 o'clock, they were just waiting for me. And after I went, I gave lecture, then till 2 o'clock devotees chant. And most devotees finish 40 or 50 rounds. So next time we can plan better. This was a spontaneous thing with a discussion with the managers, you know. We can have a system where we chant together at least once a month. That's what we said, no? Once a month or twice a month or 4 times a month. Nemina Prabhu? Once a month. Or if it is not practical here, then we can do it in our homes, wherever we are. Just like after the program here, there is some prasad, right? People will be disappointed there. Now suppose on Monday or Tuesday, there is no prasad in the temple. So what do you do? Oh, because there is no prasad in the temple, so will you fast or you will cook at home? You will cook at home. The same way, suppose in the temple it's not possible, then you should chant at home. Chanting is not, it's not that a favor we are doing to Krishna. It's for our spiritual maintenance. So like few families coming together, they can chant together. Or, you know, wherever you are, you can chant. Chanting has no restrictions. Devotees should be eager. Like our Neminath Prabhu and Murli Prabhu, they are all staying in one complex. I heard five families or something. 5-6 families. Gradually by your association, the entire building will become devotees. So 4-5 families are coming together, they can chant. I'm thinking of October 2nd. October 2nd is a holiday, right?
Yes.
So we have to go to Hyderabad now and then other places, then coming back on 1st. So 2nd October we can think, you know, if it's convenient for devotees. And maybe not in the temple, but if possible in the temple, that is best. Otherwise, in some devotees' home. Huh? Yeah. That's a very good place to chant. But irrespective, suppose I have seen devotees. One devotee was sent in the jail. She was a disciple of Sri Jayapadak Maharaj was. But 1 year back, for no reason, but some, you know, Kali Yuga, you can be put into jail for no reason. Somebody just puts a FIR against you, then without even testing, first you'll put in jail and then you have to justify. And why you should be out. Instead of first testing, first you're put in. So he was in the jail and he wrote to Sri Jayapadak Swami Maharaj. The Maharaj said, you preach in the jail, you are preaching in the jail. You are chanting 64 rounds in the jail every day. I'm not recommending that process. Okay, let us go to the jail. But Krishna may use that process if you are not, you know, just like one devotee was not getting any time for hearing, chanting and we were discussing, we were saying, I want to, but what to do, this family business, temple business. I said, real business chanting. Suddenly he was in the kirtan and he just fell down and broke his leg, and he was in the bed for almost 2 months. Then he called me up and said, "Hari Bol, looks like Krishna has some good plan for me, for Krishnanandu." And this was 2 years, 3 years back. And he used it very nicely. All the time he was in the bed, he was chanting and hearing. So we have different, Krishna has different ways. So better we accept the simple way, with good health, try to chant and hear more. So today, as I said, we are discussing this point about what we have to be careful in chanting and what is the process, this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. All that is actually a very, very simple thing, just hold the beads and listen attentively, but it's not so easy. Once when Giriraj Maharaj, disciple of Prabhupada, he lost his beads, initiated beads which were given by Srila Prabhupada. He wrote one letter to Prabhupada that, "Please give me new beads." Prabhupada says, Prabhupada chastised that, "Where are your old beads?" Then he said, "The beads which are given by the spiritual master, you should keep them very, very carefully. They are your direct link to Krishna. You should be very careful not to." Sometimes, you know, we may go to the toilet and keep the beads outside. Especially in Vrindavan, when you go to Radhamudra temple, some monkey may come and take away your beads. I was in Vrindavan last 2 weeks back, Jiva Goswami's day. I was chanting near the Samadhi, and one monkey came and he just took away the spectacle, one Mataji's. And she was just looking here and there. We tried. You have to give one fruity to the monkey and the monkey returns the beads. And that's their understanding. But this monkey, he took the fruity and did not come back. So devotee, she was so worried. She was actually crying. I saw tears. Then I realized, well, this is how I should be crying for. She is crying for spectacles, which are available for 500-600 rupees. But I am not crying for Krishna. Literally crying. She was telling me that, you know the local language, you should write a board here that monkeys are coming, beware. So much attached. Finally, she got it back. But I was thinking that when I am chanting, am I actually thinking of Krishna? That Krishna, please help me come back to you. That mood should be there, that I want to be with Krishna. Then Prabhupada wrote one letter to Radha Vallabh Prabhu. This was in the year 1972. Said, "Japa should be done in the early morning hours, preferably during Muhurat, Brahma Muhurat time." Brahma Muhurat is 1.5 hours before sunrise. And usually, I think here the sun rises around 6 o'clock or so. It is around 4:30. Because different people have different Brahmuhurats. You know, some people have Brahmuhurat, they are 7:30. They get up when the newspaper man comes. But for devotees, you should get up early in the morning. Means, at least, I would say, temple we have Mangalati at 4:30. If you are staying at home, if you are late in the night, then at least you try to be ready by 5 o'clock. And have a small aarti at your home, even if you cannot come to temple. Just sing Sansara Dhavanam, 7 to 8 minutes, 3 minutes Tulsi Puja, 3 minutes Naishinga prayer, and within half an hour you can do. You know, CMP, Compact Morning Program. You know. Now, in the age of LSI, VLSI, you can have small. But everybody should at least have a small Mangal aarti. For some devotees, they chant first and do Mangal aarti at 7:30. That's okay, but it's not the highest standard. Even if you don't have deities, you have pictures. The pictures are also non-different. Don't think that pictures are not God. Krishna can manifest through pictures also. So should offer some agarbati, something. Something to connect yourself. And this will give you a feeling of actually doing for Krishna. If you're not offering any aarti, if you're not doing any, just chanting, then you'll feel that, oh, I have to get up, I have to brush my teeth. You know, take a bath and chant. It's like tuck, 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 tuck. Bath over, you know. And chanting 1, 2, 3, 16 over. Office card punch over. Tuck. It becomes like a big mechanical process. But ideally we should be putting our heart. So the whole process is personal. Chanting is a personal process. And we don't want to just chant to fulfill some, you know, some obligation. Okay. That also is there. But oh, Prabhuji, I promised I'm chanting. More than that, it is to awaken one's relationship with Krishna, who is present in the heart as Paramatma. And he is hearing. His hearing is very, very, He is hearing every syllable. Like Haridas Thakur was chanting 3 lakhs name, 192 rounds. But every round, every word, every mantra he was hearing. So, this hearing and chanting. Like one devotee sent me a nice message, in a WhatsApp message, you know, that there is a, he has put a picture of a brain, you know, of a head. And in the back side, there is a mind. And then from the mind, the wire is coming out. And then from here, he is speaking, that is another wire, that the message. And in between the wire, there is disconnection. And it's like you connect, you know, wire connection. So the message, you are speaking, but it's not going to the mind. So we have to be very careful as we are chanting to listen attentively with genuine devotion, and that Krishna is appearing. Of course, this, all these instructions are probably, you have heard them 10, 15 times, but for the sake of my purification, for all of your purification, we are remembering again and again. Once Vishnujan Maharaj, he asked this question, Prabhupada, how is it possible for a man who is constantly absorbed in family affairs, thinking of wife, or wife thinking of husband, children, money, friend, how can he chant constantly? The mind will be distracted. So Prabhupada replied, yes, these two things will go on simultaneously. Maya will drag you towards herself and Krishna will drag you towards the holy name. This is a tug of war. Do you remember in your, you play tug of war sometimes in school or college? Yeah, Baldi Leela, you know, you pull in this way and then another person. Maya pulls you this way and then you are out, then you again pull. And it goes on and on. And but in the end, if you take shelter of Krishna, you'll be victorious. Krishna says in the Gita, Devi Esha Gunamai Mama Maya Duratyaya Mameva Prapadyante Maya Metam Taranti. That this divine energy of mine is very, very difficult to overcome. But one who surrenders to me, he can overcome. See, when you realize that I just can't chant properly, I'm helpless, Krishna, please. And then Krishna appears. And then Krishna takes over. Even in success in chanting is based not on our efforts, but on Krishna's mercy. Like there's one story in the Navadvip Dham Mahatmaya. There was a great king whose name was Samudrasen. You heard this story? Samudrasen. When you go from Calcutta to Mayapur by local train, there is one railway station called Samudragad. This Samudrasen was a very powerful king. And you know, Yudhishthira Maharaj, this was in Dwapara Yuga. So Yudhishthira Maharaj wanted to perform Rajasu Yagya. He wanted to conquer, get wealth from all the country, all the states. So he sent messengers, like Arjuna was sent in the northern direction, Bhima in the eastern direction, Nakul, Sahadev, western and southern direction. That go and challenge the king. Either they should accept that Yudhishthira is supreme and give charity, or otherwise they should fight. So this king, Samudrasen, was very powerful. He loved Bhimsen. He loved Yudhishthira. He wanted to give all necessary money to Yudhishthira Maharaj. But still he fought. Why did he fight? Anybody knows the story? He knew that Bhimsen is a pure devotee. If I fight very valiantly and put Bhimsen down to his knees, then he will helplessly cry out to Krishna and Krishna will appear and I will see Krishna. The battle was going on. It's like, suppose I am Bhim and you are Samudrasen, just for the purpose of the drama. So he's fighting with full power and Bhim was helpless. And, oh Krishna, please save me. And Krishna appeared. And Krishna was appeared behind Bhimsen. And Samudrasen thought, oh, so nice, Krishna has come, he offered Dandavat Pranam. And Bhimsen was thinking, oh, he is offering Dandavats to me. The battle was over. He got darshan of Krishna. So when a devotee actually is completely surrenders to Krishna, then he receives the help of Krishna. So Draupadi tried by her own efforts. First she started thinking, I'm not ordinary, my husbands are very powerful. What can Dushasana do? But she found that all her husbands had their head down, hung in shame. Then she turned to Bhishma and Dronacharya. Then she thought, with my own power I can protect myself. But then when she put up her hand and cried out, hey Krishna, hey Govinda, then Krishna intervened. So even in our spiritual sadhana, so long we think that I can chant properly on my effort, by my techniques, by my hints, by my knowledge of Shastra, you are not successful. But when you just say, Krishna, I am yours. Bhakti Vinod Thakur has written a very nice song. Ami to tomar, tumi to amar. What does that mean? Ami to tomar, I belong to you, and tumi to amar, you are mine. I surrender everything to you. The Bhaktivinoda Thakur, another song he says, Atma nivedana tuya pade kori hoinu paramasukhi. Atma nivedana means surrender. Tuya pade kori, I surrender to you. Hainu paramasukhi, I am perfectly happy. Dukkha dure gela chinta na rohila. All dukkha, unhappiness, distress, dur gela. Well, and chinta, no anxiety. Chaudi ke ananda dekhi, everywhere I see happiness. The child doesn't have any anxiety. He has to just catch on to the hand of the mother and the father. The devotee is surrendered. Krishna and yours. Krishna's protection comes in proportion to your dependence on him. If you to the degree you depend on Krishna, you will experience Krishna's mercy. Generally, what will happen when the danger comes, we call I, mother, father, husband, wife, children, and then doctor, and then nothing works, then Krishna, you are also there. They say, Prabhuji, now my relatives are in the very difficult state, Krishna will help. That is good, but actually, you should remember from Krishna from the beginning. Because Krishna is right there. Even the best medicines, they will work if Krishna wants. And if Krishna does not want, then even the best medicines will not work. So here Prabhupada is saying, Maya is very strong. She will force you to, entice you to other path. But you should just go on loudly chanting. And here Prabhupada gives a very famous example. What is that famous example of somebody who is tested by Maya? Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur was tested. His only formula was, I have not finished my rounds. Of course, it doesn't mean that he did not chant. No, you can also imitate that. Probably I did not finish. Why? Because Haridas Thakur also would not finish. So I am following his footsteps now. Haridas would not finish means he would go on chanting. Because he was relishing. So this is a tug of war, but don't be afraid of Maya. Simply enhance your chanting and you will be the conqueror. This is a lecture on Bhagavad Gita given by Srila Prabhupada on December 13, 1968 in Los Angeles. Kaunteya pratijanihi name bhaktya pranashyati. O son of Kunti, declare it boldly that my devotee will never perish. So that means devotee will never be defeated. We may be defeated temporarily, but in the end Krishna is there. I lose the battle, but finally the war, Krishna will help. Okay, we'll pause for any... Jai Jagannath Swami ki jai. We will pause for any questions or comments related to this, what we discuss. How do we push ourselves? If you are advanced, then you will push yourself naturally. If you are not advanced, then you should read the books and get inspiration from the books. Or even better, get pushed by other devotees who are helping. Husband and wife should push each other. Husband should encourage the wife to increase chanting, the wife to encourage the husband. Or for that matter, brahmacharis push each other, encourage each other. You know what I read about chanting today? I'd like to share with you. The latest lecture I heard from Prabhupada, disciple, this is what I heard. You know, I heard one point from one senior devotee in the online lecture, like that. That will make family life also spiritual. Otherwise, what do you have to discuss? It's just, this problem, that problem, and anxiety. So this discussion like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he says, when I come home, I see my home has become Goloka Vrindavan. So the family, there has to be slight pushing, encouragement, not forceful pushing, but loving pushing, and helping each other. After all, somebody must have pushed me, so that's why I'm able to progress. Somebody must have pushed you, so you've come to this level of chanting 16 rounds. Very few are there who just get up at the age of 16, just say, I want to chant 16, now 32, I want to surrender. Some pushing is needed, but that pushing should be very loving, not forceful, but gently, not very gentle, or some pushing is there. And how do you push yourself? A very good question. When you read and chant, then automatically you feel inspired. Like why I feel inspired to speak so much? Because I'm always reading, chanting. So even if I don't want to, I cannot remain without speaking. I feel happy. there you get a taste. And then when you get a taste, then if somebody tells you, Prabhuji, enough, our devotees are very tired, now let us take a break, you know. But then I will not feel, hey, Prabhupada, I am just following Prabhupada. Prabhupada was, I mean, I am just 56, Prabhupada was 77, 80, almost 80 when he left the planet. He was pushing himself so much. See, just he was in Vrindavan, doctor came, just appeared, he was going to leave his body. And then Vrindavan, doctor told him, okay, now we are giving him medicine. But after this, if you leave Vrindavan, we cannot guarantee whether you will survive. And then after a few months, he recovered. Then he got a message from London devotees, hey, please come. And Prabhupada went to London. And sure enough, he actually felt deteriorated. Then he came back and left his body. So he knew that the higher principle is to please the devotees. So automatically that pushing will come. And like the hearing chanting is the catalyst. It's like if a vehicle is maintained very nicely, and petrol is kept nicely, oil is there, then you press the accelerator, automatically it will move forward. The maintenance is not good, even if you just start in between, it will stop so many times, and then, you know, it will maintain your spiritual life. But if you are doing Mangalarti every day, even at 5 o'clock at home, and chanting all your rounds before breakfast, and reading at least half hour, then automatically you will feel inspired. And if you chant, like I was just, I got a call from one very good friend of mine, disciple of Bhakti Vikas Maharaj. Is in Hyderabad. So next weekend he's called me, some programs. They were small township called Singapore Township, you know, the IT. So he was telling me he's in Dubai now. He said, I'm feeling so weak, Dubai, Muscat, going to these places. Of course, there are ISKCON centers, but somehow he could not get time to go. He said, I want to come and just we'll chant together. You know. So when he does the morning program nicely, he says, I feel completely enlivened. But if it's traveling in Dubai and Muscat and change of time zones and chanting becomes disturbed, so then automatically things slow down. It's like yesterday, you had to take a late night flight, you know, because you are very determined. So you slept at 1:30, again got up and came. So you are asking this question, I should be asking, because you are already pushing yourself. You know, generally, a person traveling whole night from late night flight would be flat. You appear that as if you have nothing and you had very good rest. So I'm asking you how to, you should answer this question. Yes, a good example you are setting. Yes, your Murli Prabhu, see his enthusiasm. He's every day there in Mangalarti. And Brahmacharya may be still sleeping, but he's there here. You know, just there's so many examples here. So many Matajis are coming regularly. One or two Matajis come every day for help in cutting vegetables for the devotees. And so we have a very nice temple. But of course, I am not fully satisfied. I expect all of you to come more often. Don't wait for your Guru Maharaj to send you a mail that please come for Mangalarti. My Guru Maharaj never told, I took a vow of chanting 16 rounds for him. I never gave took a vow, I will attend Mangalarti. But you never took a vow that you will eat prasad every day. I'm not saying every day, but like now we are doing on Sunday, once a week everybody comes, you know. So try to make it twice a week. Or if not feasible here, like in your society, there are 5 families, so we can keep one day rotation, Mangalarti, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And this way, everybody will get up, you know, because the psychological pressure is there. If I don't come, what will Neminathru think about me, you know. So, like that. The social pressure, like Bharat Maharaj, what was his problem? He was on the bhava level, he was associating with the Lord, he was chanting, tears were coming out. But then he became attached to a deer. Nothing wrong with saving a deer, but he became so attached that during Mangalarti, deer, during Japa, deer, my dear, deer. Now if Bharat Maharaj would have some, you know, some group which was coming together for Mangalarti, then somebody would have asked, Hari Bol, Bharat Prabhu, aapka darshan nahi hua, we didn't have your darshan, like a very sarcastically. Then devotees sometimes lovingly chastise their artha, that is for our good. So, Prabhuji, I didn't see you in Mangalarti today. I was not there in Bhagavatam. So that way, indirectly, we are checking on each other. If devotees don't help you, who will help you? Don't expect that Krishna will come out of the altar to help you. That may happen for a very special devotee. But Krishna is also in the heart of all the Vaishnavas. So the Vaishnavas have to care for each other. This is spiritual care. Otherwise, if you are not interested in spiritual care, then it becomes like a mundane organization. In the mundane world also people care for each other. How are you? How is your wife? How is your husband? How are children? Studies are going well. Children's marriage is getting fixed up nicely. House loan is being paid. Like that, these kind of thoughts. Devotees also can discuss this as a side matter. But that should not be the main agenda. Otherwise, what is the difference between us and non-devotees? Everywhere this problem of survival is going to be there. Okay, anybody else? But any Mataji have any questions? Yes, Mataji. You can do it 5 or 5:30. What I was referring to is that you don't have to come to temple necessarily. At home, just sing. It takes 5 minutes for Sansara Dhamana, 3 minutes Hare Krishna. Prabhupada said actually, I don't remember the exact sentence, but Prabhupada said majority of the Mangal Arati should be Hare Krishna mantra, like 8 to 10. So totally you can, according to your budget, 10 minutes for the whole Mangal Arati, 5 minutes Tulsi Puja, 5, like in 20 to 25 minutes you can finish. Here we finish in half an hour, so at home it will be faster. Lord is more merciful at home. And less members, and everybody, you know, once the husband is offering, next day the wife is offering, so everybody gets a chance to sing. It's more personal then. You have pictures of the deities at home, right? Or you have, you have deities are there. So yeah, I remember. Yeah. So the deity, that is more personal. In one sense, home worship has got a special feature that personal deities are there. You know, so then you should. Of course, it's always recommended the temple is better, but considering the distance, considering the schedule and practicalities, once a week you come to temple, but every day, the home. It's very nice. I remember I had, when I was staying in a flat in Pune, one devotee had a vacant flat and I was staying there near the temple, but I had my own deities. I would go to the morning program also in the temple, but before that I would wake the deities. My deities were very special. I would get up at 3:30 only. Wooden deities. So not much time is needed, but just little wait. And traveling, we cannot have deities. When somebody asks, like some sannyasis have their deities, Nashinga Srila, some have Gauranitai. Somebody asked, like one devotee, His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj, which are your deities? So Maharaj took out his bead bag and said, these are my deities. Because chanting Hare Krishna is worshipping the deity. So chanting is also puja. In fact, Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Nahi naam dham, nahi naam sama dharma, nahi naam sama vrata. Chanting the holy name is the biggest puja. So, it should be done in that mood. Okay. Priority is a brief Mangal Arati and 16 rounds. Other things can wait. Suppose you are not able to get time for hearing Bhagavatam, that's solid. But this 16 rounds we should finish. Prefer it before you go to your workplace. Once you go to workplace, then it becomes evening. And also you should encourage to take early rest. You see, although sometimes I can start the class late, but at 9 sharp I end everything in the temple. Out of concern for all of you and concern for myself. If you end at 9, then little prasad, 9:15, 9:30, 10 o'clock you reach home. Then 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock latest we should try to take rest. Now there are some special cases, like there are programs are there, sometimes becomes late, that you cannot help. But whenever it's possible, take early rest. And actually, according to scientists, Ayurvedic doctors, sleeping 1 hour before 12 is equal to sleeping 2 hours after 12. I heard like this. Is it true, Mataji? It's more healthy? Here we have expert Ayurvedic doctor here. Eh? Is it true like that, what I said? Sleeping early is good. But early to sleep, early to rise also. Not early to sleep and late to rise. Devotees are very expert, they can use things here and there. And take very light food, like it says, you know, take breakfast like a prince, lunch like a king, and dinner like a pauper. Just take minimal, like, best is to take some very light khichdi or soup or some milk. Not heavy grains, if you take parotta and pizza in the night, you know, then you make a pizza of your bhakti and you will not be able to. It should be light so that in the morning you are fresh. The digestion has taken place. Ideally, not to take any grains after sunset. Or take minimal, because, you know, it's not for us, brahmacharya, it's easy, but for grahasthas, to adjust schedule. And also the wife, Obviously, they like to serve in the night time. In the daytime, they can't cook fancy items, you know. So, in the night time, that tendency is there, let me serve. And that's not wrong, because that is the one of the exchanges in family life. So, we should try to dovetail that on holidays, you know, or keep it light. It can be tasty, but light. So that by the time morning, you don't have any difficulty in keeping your body clean and you are fresh. Because so many diseases come out of just indigestion. Most of the diseases are because of indigestion. And most of them are because we eat late in the night and we eat more. Like Bengali, they are saying, khaiba ki na khaiba na khaiba. If you have doubt whether I should take more or not, better don't take. And Prabhupada, same thing. Our Ashok Gaur Prabhu is here, I think. He was expressing. You were saying that within Madhu Dvish Prabhu, Australia? What was that sentence? I'll repeat the Prabhuji, saying that devotees can make two mistakes about prasadam. What is that?
One mistake is overeating.
One is overeating.
The other is
undereating.
If at all you want to make a mistake, make the mistake of eating less.
Prabhuji is saying that if at all you make a mistake, you should make mistake of eating less. Mataji, you are hearing, you remind Prabhuji this. Huh? Next time when you are... It is being recorded also. No? But Ashok Babu is a very self-controlled person, so this problem is not there. But it's actually a challenge, because you know the main pleasure in material life is eating and sex life. Sex life of course can be controlled, but eating is a daily exercise. And if you can control eating and sex life, then you are as good as sannyas. Then you are fit to go back to Godhead. So that tongue, dharmade jivadi, you have to control. Although prasad is Krishna, but still, like Prabhupada, when he first started ISKCON, he found people were going to that, Baskin, that they have this bakery, the cakes, pastries. And Prabhupada said, no, don't go outside, just eat prasad, eat as much as you like, as many times, no problem. The devotees, you know, they're very selective, guru vakya, you know. So they started eating too much. And then Prabhupada said, actually, you should take only as much as you need. The devotees said, Prabhupada, first you told you can eat as much as you like, now you are changing. Prabhupada said, when I gave first instruction, you did not ask any question. So now also, you should not ask any question. So Prabhupada would give instruction according to the level. In one place, Prabhupada said, sannyasi means one who can eat with the eyes. We should look at this, very nice, I am satisfied. That is your sannyasi. You can see, yeah, this is nice, rasgulla, Krishna has eaten, yes. I am honored. Or just one. Ultimately, the less you eat, less you sleep, the more you will likely to go back to God. Because back to God means ultimately giving up eating, sleeping and being absorbed in chanting. But if we artificially try to do it, we may die. We may die physically or die spiritually also. Like a madman. If you don't eat properly, if you don't sleep properly, your brain will not function properly. So everything has to be balanced. Okay, any other questions? Yes. Govinda Sundar Prabhu. Very good question. Prabhuji is asking, is there any assessment we can have whether we are improving or whether we are going down? The main sign of good chanting is should be attentive, and the next step is getting a taste for the holy name. First step is attentive chanting, and second step, as you advance, will be getting taste. At least we should be attentive. That means, like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Nayanam galada shudhara, when my eyes will be filled with tears. We can say at least when my eyes will be awake during japa. That is the first step. Nayanam unmilitam, that is a big thing. If you can remain awake, from my experience, less than 25% devotees are able to remain awake all throughout chanting. Include senior, so-called senior person like me. So many times I have to struggle. So that may be partially because of lack of rest or maybe because of lack of taste. Whatever be the reason, the end result is bad. So you have to work on it. Just like, you know, you're always thinking your daughter Lalita is there. If she has any problem, health, you're taking care. So you have to take care of your own spiritual life yours. And nobody else can monitor it as nicely as you can. Because I cannot judge how attentive you are. You have to judge. And in the end, you will have to face the consequences. If you are not able to chant properly, that means you have to take another birth to perfect it. Nothing wrong with that, but if you can do it now, that's why it's, so this chanting is an emergency. Why I put so much emphasis? Because, you know, you may satisfy the temple authorities, do whatever seva you are told, but chanting is something which even the temple authorities cannot always check. You have to check yourself. It's like, how much is food is enough? It's not like there is a meter connected to the stomach. It goes like this, you know, barometer, and then a doctor will not monitor from outside. You have to judge, this is enough for me. The same way chanting, we have to see, am I improving? It's a very good question you asked for the welfare of all. That, you know, we have to check. Am I becoming more humble? Am I becoming more proud? You know? Am I actually learning to respect others? Or am I learning to respect myself? Is my behavior very gentle, or am I very arrogant? These are some of the signs of the phalena pariche. If you are chanting nicely, it should manifest in your behavior. Any devotee would like to add to this answer or any other question? Okay, so we'll go to the next reference. One devotee asked Prabhupada, your Guru Maharaj Bhakti Siddhanta, you see the picture there, Bhakti Thakur, he was always sitting like this, erect. So Prabhupada, he was sitting erect. So, in the Bhagavad Gita also says that yogi should sit erect. So, will this help? Prabhupada said, no, it is not compulsory, but it will help you. And he was saying that actually this is a sign of a real brahmacharya. Or even a grihastha who has very controlled sense gratification, he'll be able to sit erect for a long time. And that is a very good sign. It helps. And also, my experience, if you want to sleep, hopefully nobody wants to, but there's a formula for that also. You just have your two hands come little close to each other and bow down little bit. And it's like this, so that nobody knows. You know? Then you go, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. This is how, I mean, devotees are very, very tired, they want to take rest in japa. Knowingly or unknowingly, the two hands come closer. Instead of being erect, it goes like this. Like this, and then somebody wakes you up. Says, I was not sleeping. So this posture makes a difference. Although it is not critical. Sometimes, you know, with age, it's difficult to sit erect for a long time. That's why sitting on chair is also all right. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur would walk and chant also. I personally feel better to sit and chant at least first 16 rounds. Because if you walk, general tendency is that the mind will wander. But then Prabhupada himself sometimes walked, so we cannot say it is wrong. But if you sit and chant, that is better. And also we should be careful to hear the mantra. And also chant, but not so loudly so as to disturb others chanting. Sometimes devotees, they chant like, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. I am the only one to purify the whole congregation. Out of kindness, I am chanting loudly. It should be very easy. Because everybody has to hear their own mantra. Careful. Okay, anything else? Any other hints or any other techniques what you may have heard? When we do group japa, but if it is disturbing, then one of the two options, either you can go away a little bit, or you can humbly request that, please chant a little softer. Because, you know, like when you're driving also, or you have to, and everybody has to drive. If somebody thinks I am the only one on the road, and he just keeps on banging vehicles, it will not be good. So everybody wants to go, like I was coming from Malleshwaram just now, and said, you know, long drive, so many vehicles just, like all the rivers merging in the ocean, you know, sometimes. So, I mean, every vehicle has to enter, but if you become humble and so, he's going fast, let him go, let him, then you will never drive, you will just be waiting. You have to also be gentle in driving, but you have to push yourself first. In the same way, one has to see, Prabhuji, I am very respectful to you, Mataji, I like your chanting, it's so kind of you that you're liberating so many living beings, the microbes and, you know, ants and mosquitoes, but I am also one of them. Please let me chant. I want to hear my whole mantra, or just move aside a little bit. I mean, this is my suggestion. Somebody else may have a different opinion. What do you think, Prabhupada? I was one actually like that. I would chant very loudly. But when once I was corrected by Maharaj, one devotee, so I said, okay, let me just try to be. So sometimes what happens, the devotees put earplugs. So they have earplugs. They don't know how loud they are chanting. And they are getting their own mantra. And they are least bothered about what anybody else is chanting. And they just go like a warrior. And Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Like in a Kargil border. You know, to hell with the Pakistanis and everybody. So it's good. Enthusiasm is good. But it should be coupled with intelligence and proper understanding. Everything in devotional services to be balanced. If you are going all alone in the forest, then nobody cares. Then you can chant loudly. Sometimes you walk on the street, it is not disturbing to others now. But otherwise you should be very gentle. And also another thing, if you chant too loudly, you can't chant for a long time because you become tired. It should be good enough, Prabhupada says, that you can hear and just the neighbor can hear, like that much. Just every word should be kind. Okay. Next. With Preeti. This is a lecture by Prabhupada given in Mayapur in 1973, Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto. So, Krishna is always ready to help us, provided we are ready to cooperate with Him. If you cooperate with Him, whatever Krishna desires, if you do that, then Krishna will help you. If you work 1% towards Krishna, Krishna will help you 10%. If you take one step towards Krishna, Krishna will take 10 steps. And what is the size of Krishna's step? In Vamanadev, you know, in one step he took everything. The entire Bangalore, and all the metro systems. He took the ocean and the rivers. So one step is needed. And then Prabhupada concludes by saying, if you are engaged satatam kirtayanto mam, 24 hours, then Krishna is very happy. But tesham satatam yuktana bhajatam preeti. The key word is preeti. What does preeti mean? Love. So I gave the example of gulab jamun. The gulab jamun, after being the balls being fried, it should be put in the juice, sugar juice. It should be kept for a long time so that all the juice enters. So when we are chanting, we should be with preeti is the juice, with love. With love and attention. And suppose you make a juice, but you don't forget to put sugar. Say the gulab jamun may be wet, but it will not taste nice. So we should always be thinking, the chanting means cooking for Krishna. The holy name is an item. And to the degree I chant attentively, to that degree it will be tasty. Like anybody cooking for the Lord will make sure that there are no sand particles in the kheer. So the Harinam is like kheer, very sweet. But the offenses and inattention are like the sand particles. So we should weed out those particles so that we can. Our chanting should be for the pleasure of Krishna. Ultimately, we are chanting just to please Krishna. If Krishna is pleased, our chanting is perfect. And then Prabhupada says, we should chant properly, not hackneyed. We should not go like Prabhupada is saying, Hare Krishna, 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 Krishna. He does like that, actually. Not like that. Chant every name, Hare Krishna, and here. Hare, here is Radharani. Krishna, here is Krishna. Like that, think like this. And this kind of chanting is called quality chanting. One devotee had an accident in Prabhupada's Lila, Allen's Ginsberg. And Prabhupada got the news in 1966-68. You heard about Allen's Ginsberg? Huh? Poet, a singer also. So Prabhupada wrote to him, I am very disturbed to hear about your accident and I was anxious to learn that you are now lying in a hospital. I hope you are progressing. But my request is that you continue to chant Hare Krishna. Here is a chance for you to chant Hare Krishna exclusively in the hospital bed. Nobody will disturb you. So Prabhupada is, and Prabhupada directly said, oh, very good. You know, you are in hospital, chant more. You would have felt bad. So first Prabhupada says, oh, I'm very disturbed. I'm feeling sorry that you are in the hospital. And please, I am happy that you are pro-. But nevertheless, you chant more and more. So Prabhupada is balancing very nicely, giving medicine but with sugar coating also. You could have said, you know, you are in hospital, very good Baba, chant. The devotee will feel very bad. I am suffering. And he is saying, very good. So Prabhupada said, very good one. Then Prabhupada concludes by saying, this world is full of dangers, padam padam yadipadam. But you take shelter of Krishna, bhajam hure mane shri nandananda. By Krishna's mercy, we can cross hundreds of pits. This material world is the ocean of one small pit. But by Krishna's mercy, you can cross just by chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Prabhupada says in one lecture in Bhagavad Gita in Calcutta in 1974, this is the Radhashtami lecture. Prabhupada says, so today is Radhashtami, so Hare, who is this Hare? Srimati Radharani. Radha or Hara is the same thing. We are praying to Radharani, O Mother Radharani, O Krishna. First to Radharani, then Krishna. We don't say Krishna Hare, but Radhe Hare Krishna, Radhe Krishna, Lakshmi Narayan, not Narayan Lakshmi, Ram Sita, Sita Ram. Because when you go to Krishna, Krishna may not accept you. You want Krishna, please accept me, Krishna. Who is this? Check his past records, my God. 2 TB hard disk full. No hope. When you go to Radharani, and Radharani prays, oh, this devotee is better than me. The Mahabhagavat always feels other devotee is better. He's better than me. Now Krishna knows that you are rascal. I'm talking about myself. But when Radharani says, Krishna can never refuse. So that's why Prabhupada writes, Krishna tava punya hobe bhai. O punya kori be jabe, Radharani khushi habe, Dhruva ati boli toma thai. Oh my dear brothers, I declare emphatically that you will receive Krishna's mercy when Radharani is pleased with you. In fact, today is the day when Prabhupada reached Boston, right, September 21st. And this is the prayer he wrote when he reached Boston. So you can meditate on this prayer, that Krishna will be pleased when Radharani is pleased. So Prabhupada writes actually in one place, sometimes you see in deity of Krishna, there is a Radharani is having some flowers. So Prabhupada said, when you offer flower, you should think that you are offering to Srimati Radharani. And then Krishna, she is offering to Krishna. You cannot offer to Krishna directly. Or in our case, we offer to our spiritual master. He offers to his spiritual master, Prabhupada. Prabhupada offers to his spiritual master. And in this parampara, the flower is representing our heart. Our heart is a flower, but it, instead of having fragrance, it has got a dirty odor. It is bad smelling, foul smelling. When we offer it to Guru, he purifies the flower and adds the fragrance of Shuddha Bhakti and makes the offering pleasing to Krishna. So that's why we always approach Krishna through Srimati Radharani. And Radhe, the word Radha actually has got several meanings. But said that when somebody chants the name Ra, Krishna becomes so happy, he comes running behind. Maybe he will say Radha. That's why we always chant Hare Krishna mantra. Not Krishna. Other mantras are also good, but Lord Chaitanya chose this mantra. Krishna likes the name of Radharani, Radharani likes the name of Krishna. So to please both of them, we chant Hare Krishna. Radha and Krishna, both of them. And the meaning of this mantra is, O Radharani, O Krishna, please engage me in your service. Next is a lecture by Prabhupada in Mayapur, 1977, the last year of Prabhupada's manifest pastime. He's telling the story of, can you tell me what story is it? Somebody who's in great danger and he cries to Krishna. Gajendra. How did you guess? Great danger. That means you are always thinking of, this world is also danger. College also. Everywhere there is danger. So, when I said college, the Shankar blew. If you are forgetting Krishna, then it's danger. If you are remembering Krishna, you can go to the jaws of death and not be affected also. Like Prahlad was taking poison, but he was fearless. So Prabhupada writes here, the king of elephants, Gajendra, you know, he was attacked by a crocodile. I mean, he was actually playing in the water. It was with Mr. Gajendra, Mrs. Gajendra, and baby Gajendra. Probably a Sunday morning or something like that. Because Gajendra do not go for Bhagavatam class. You know, so he was just enjoying, like, weekly off, you know. And Suddenly, he found that this crocodile just caught hold of him. This is in its material world. It's like, the, I think yesterday it was when one of the banks, the building was on fire. UCO Bank, I saw it on the mobile, you know. I don't know, hopefully everybody survived. Huh? Nothing happened. Some people were trying to jump off the building and so what can we say? Hopefully it will not happen to Punjab National Bank. I don't know what can happen to any bank, you know. And can happen to your home. What can we do? There's no insurance that the bank will not burn. Only insurance that after you die you may get some money. That is insurance. What kind of insurance is this? So only insurance, real insurance is not LIC, KIC. Krishna Insurance Company. LIC says Yoga Chema Vaham. They have stolen it from Krishna actually. Maybe we can file a case against them. You know? This is Krishna's word and they are saying Yoga Chema Vaham. They are banking money on it, you know. Or they should give 10% discount. You know? Then you are using my slogan, you know. Like in the world, you know, like suppose like there is some company has a certain trademark, if you use it, you can be sued for that, correct? Yes, yes. They say they use the tricks like Redmi, Realme, like that. They trick each other. But of course, but this, the fact is that there is danger every step. The Prabhupada writes here, this Gajendra, he was fighting. But one thing good, the crocodile, Prabhupada said, crocodile did some service also. Why? He touched the feet of a great Vaishnava. Gajendra was a king in the last life, was Indradyumna. So he caught hold of the feet. Now this is not the right way of touching also, you know. Like some Vaishnava is going and you pull him down. What Prabhuji, I heard that I must take the dust. Arey Baba, I am lying down. People are watching me, you know. I am wearing dhoti and no, somebody told me I must catch the dust of your feet. It happened in America once. Two devotees are catching dust and one of them was bedridden for 3 months. Yes, but I got the dust. I don't care you are 3 months in bed. I got your mercy. What kind of mercy is this? So, but this Gajendra, because he's an elephant and a crocodile is an animal. So, an animal, there is not so much etiquette strictly for following. So, and he saved, he took the shelter of, somehow or other, Gajendra took the shelter of Krishna. He also tried his best. Tug of war went on. He said the war went on for thousands of years. Because this was during Satyuga time. The elephants would live long, long, long life. But finally, he understood. Only Krishna can save me. And then he cried out, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. So Prabhupada, in this lecture, he says, bhakti is such a nice thing that if you can please Krishna, Krishna will be there to help you. But in the case of Gajendra, the Lord came on riding on the Garuda and just with his chakra, he cut off the head of the crocodile. The crocodile was also fortunate to be killed by Krishna. He was a Gandharva in his past life, right? What was his name? Hoo-hoo. There were two Gandharvas. Please do not laugh. Just repeat after me. Ha-ha. Hoo-hoo. Ha-ha, hoo-hoo. So this was a Gandharva. Very, I don't know how they get these names, but very nice names. Ha-ha, hoo-hoo. You know? Suppose they are twins in one home and the mother is calling, ha-ha, hoo-hoo, please come here. Very interesting, right? So, who is who? Who who is who? Who who is was a, in his last life he was a Gandharva, I think. Right? His name was who that time. So this Gandharva, he did some offense. He was cursed to become a crocodile, but he was saved because he attacked a Vaishnava. But somehow, you know, somehow you meet a Vaishnava, even if you apparently, you know. Apparently offend a Vaishnava, ultimately that will come out for their good. Like Nalakuvera Manikriva. They offended Narad Muni. I mean, it's very shameless behavior. A great sadhu is passing boy and you are not even so courteous to wear proper clothes. It is very disrespectful. What is Vaishnava etiquette? It's human etiquette, Gandharva etiquette, you know. But although they offended Narad Muni, they got cursed. But that curse will not be a blessing. Cursed to become trees, but where? In Gokul. It's a great blessing. A non-devotee, even if he blesses you, it is a curse. If he bless you, get good money, good house, good family life and happily go to hell next birth. And a Vaishnava may curse you also, but that curse becomes a blessing. Of course, we should not do something which will cause the anger of a Vaishnava. But nevertheless, Vaishnavas are like antiseptic. Somehow or other, whatever they come into contact, they will purify them. Narada Muni got his mercy from the Bhakti Vedantas. When he was a small child, he was serving great devotees and getting their remnants. And that's how he became a great devotee. Then Prabhupada says, we should have this mood in chanting. Sometimes I picture like this while chanting, that I am like Gajendra and Maya is attacking me. And then I chant. Then I'm going to chant very nicely. Prabhupada says, when you are chanting Hare Krishna, you should be saying, Ai Nanda Tanuja Kinkaram Patitam Mam Vishame Bhavam Budau Kripaya Tava Pada Pankaja Siddhaduli Sadrisham Vichintaya. Oh, my dear son of Maharaj Nanda, I am drowning in this ocean of birth and death. Please come and pick me up and place me as one of the atoms at your lotus feet. Now, what does it mean to be a particle of dust at Krishna's lotus feet? It means to be engaged in devotional service. Okay, thus we have finished one chapter today, and I had planned three chapters, but I think we will be able to do only one more. But we will pause here for any comments. We are fortunate to discuss Mathura Shyam Prabhu is also here today. We would like to hear his comments. Let us be discussing about chanting, you know, that how to chant and Prabhupada's instruction. This is the book which I was recommending devotees, chanting Hare Krishna. So some copies we are getting for our ICC center. Those who like, you can give the names to. You can collect the names or. Nevinath Prabhu. Very, very useful. It helped me improve my chanting by at least 30-40% within a year. Any comments or questions? Yes. Not Shri, but Shri Balaji Prabhu. But non different.
So, holy also removes the propensity.
That is. Very good question. We are saying that holy name not only removes the sinful reactions, but also removes the tendency to perform sinful reaction. But we see we are chanting for decade to decade and still the propensity is still there. So how do we understand? You see, what I understand is that we have been in this material world for such long duration of time. So at least we should try to chant at least 1% or 0.00% 1% of time that we have been in the material world. It takes time. Like you have kept the house closed for, suppose you go out of the house for Diwali or for Yatra, come back after 1 month, there's so much dust in the home. Can you imagine you open your home after 2 years, you may find some lizards, some scorpions also, you know, so much dirt. So we have been in this material world for how many years? Can anybody estimate? I'll make a very gross estimate which may not be accurate, but give some idea. Now we have 84 lakh species of life. Assuming we have gone through this chakra for at least 10 times. Yani ka ni cha papa ni, you know. So 84 lakh into 10, how much is that? 8.4 crore births we have got. And assuming a minimum of 10 years per birth. Sometimes, you know, plants live for 1,000 years. Some mosquitoes, ants, they die in 1 day. So average, it's a 10 years. That 10 years into 8.4 crore, that comes to 84 crore years. I'm just, it may be less or more, but 84 crore years you have been in this material world. So let us chant at least for 1% of 84 crore years. How much is that? Here in bank, you must be knowing, you always do percentages. No? 84 lakhs. Oh, if not, then let us do 1% of 1%. How much is that? 84,000. If not that, let us do 1% of 1% of 1%. How much is that? 840 years. Even not then, let us do 10% of 840 years. How much is that? 84. So, we chant for 84 years, then we will discuss. By that time, now your age is 40? 40. Huh? 47 plus 84, that is 120, 130. So, Shri Balaji, Babaji, Maharaj, if you are alive, by that time the head will be touching the stomach and the stick, you can show your photographs. You know, I was working. Hopefully you will all live long, but beyond 100 is unthinkable. How many people are there in Bangalore with plus 100 plus age? Maybe a dozen or maybe 100. It's unlikely. And even if you are, it's so much. I mean, I personally would not like to live so much, become a burden on somebody, you know. It's best to live, I mean, whenever Krishna wants. We should try to prolong it. We should not say, okay, Prabhupada told in the lecture, so today I will just, we should try to live as much. Take nice chyavanprash, or you can consult Ayurvedic doctors, you know. But ultimately, like one of my friend was saying, Prabhuji, I will live for 150 years. I may not die. I said, why? He said, I am eating chyavanprash. I said, chyavanprash, you take the Dabar, Jhandu, Vedyanath and now our Patanjali. So you take all four and mix and still you will die. Because chyavanprash was invented by Chyavan Rishi. And where is he now? And if he was effective, he would have lived. So, you know, what Ayurveda can do is just apparently prolong, because it's ultimately it's a karma. Like one devotee called up, he said, from Pune, he said, now my wife was suffering for so much. Now after 5 days, we got a good doctor. After the third doctor who understands the problem. So I told him, when your karma gets over, then you meet a good doctor. You know, it's a karma, like in the doctor's karma to get some money from you. And then that when that karma is eradicated, then you meet a doctor. Without doctor also you get. So I personally don't go to any doctors. I go sometimes to preach. You know, so that they start chanting, say, okay, this, please take my medicine. Mostly I go and leave, they give free medicines. Why should I spend Krishna? So when they agree to take my medicine, I take their medicine. So they chant little bit, I eat little bit. Then after some time, then Hari Bol. If they continue, then we can. Because ultimately my medicines cannot help. But still we should go, because that is also part of Krishna's arrangement. The doctors are there. Doctors have worked hard for their degrees, so they should also get some customers, you know. But ultimately, Krishna is the only doctor. Sometimes we see devotees, we have poor people who have got healthy bodies, and rich people who consult doctors, and still they have got so many diseases. Like I told you about one case, this devotee who is young, and his wife is 38 years old, and the fourth stage of cancer in Vrindavan, and I'm praying for her. Today evening also, every day I'm remembering. So, you know, very, both of husband and wife are engineers, America, earning thousands of dollars, but yet now on no cure, I mean, doctors have given up. It's only Krishna who decides. But at the same time, this Ayurveda or any, ultimately all this medical science is part of Krishna's, they must take advantage. Like Murari Gupta, he was a good doctor. But what he would do is, along with the medicine, he would give the Hare Krishna mantra. So that is perfection. Okay, we have only 15 minutes left. Any other comments or questions relating to the discussion? Mathura Shyam Prabhu is a very wonderful preacher. The other day I went to his Bhakti Kuti. So many, a small group but very enthusiastic devotees. He's given them the culture of hearing and chanting. Association of devotees. Okay, another chapter which I wanted to discuss a little bit was about actually 2-3 chapters, but today we will try to discuss one and tomorrow maybe. Prabhupada tells one story here about Ramanujacharya. He is a liberated person from the very birth. He is a pure devotee. But in the external Leela, he was, you know, studying under Yadav Prakash. And then he had Shiksha Gurus like Kanchi Purna, Mahapurna, Shaila Purna. Then he was told to take mantra from Goshti Purna. So he went to Goshti Purna and asked for the mantra. He said, no, you are not qualified. Come again later. And this went on for 17 times. He was refused. And finally, the Lord Himself told the Pujari, go and tell Goshti Purna that Ramanujacharya is the most qualified person. Give him the mantra. So then Goshti Purna called him and said, I'll give you the mantra. It's the most powerful mantra. It can eradicate all sufferings, but it's a secret mantra. Please do not tell anyone. And he gave him the mantra, which is Om Namo Narayana. Ramanujacharya was thinking, this mantra can reduce suffering. They just called everybody, please come, you are all dear to me, then my very life, I want to give you something most invaluable. And then he told them to chant, Om Namo Narayanaya.
Your
voice is like somebody is doing Dirijala Vrata. Please chant loudly. Om Namo Narayanaya.
Om Namo Narayanaya.
Om Namo Narayanaya.
Om Namo Narayanaya.
And you know the story of he told everybody, please chant, go to your homes. And then Goshipuna was outraged, he was so angry. God says, you are a rascal. We told you, you know what the reaction will be. You are disobeying your own guru. He said, yes, I know the reaction. I have to go to hell. But you mentioned that by this mantra, so many people will be freed from suffering. So I was thinking, if so many people are freed from suffering, then if one insignificant person like me has to go to hell, what is the loss? Goshipuna heard this, he started crying. He fell at the feet of Ramacharya. He said, actually, you are fit to be my guru. But Ramacharya said, no, I am just your servant. So this was told by Prabhupada that this is the mood of a preacher. He is willing to risk, like Vasudeva Datta Thakur. He was asked by the Lord, what do you want? And he prayed, my Lord, if it pleases you, let all the sinful reactions come to me. Let all living beings go back to God. And if they are too sinful, let their karma come to me. And let me suffer forever. And Lord Chaitanya says, do not worry, your desire will be fulfilled and you don't have to suffer. In one section of Chaitanya Charitamrita, Kaviraj Goswami compares Lord Chaitanya to a gardener, a mali. The gardener is planting the fruit of love of God, and is distributing the fruit. So Lord Chaitanya is saying, I am a gardener and I want to distribute to everybody, not considering who is fit, who is unfit. He distributed to everybody this fruit of love of God. And then he asked all of us, you please come and assist me in distributing this fruit. That's what our whole temple preaching activities, ultimately it is part of distribution of the holy name. The whole purpose of this International Society for Krishna Consciousness is to assist Srila Prabhupada and their representatives in distributing the holy name. We should not neglect other services thinking, oh, only holy name is important. But we should be cautious not to neglect the holy name also. And our life should be so simple that we have more time for the holy name. A very practical example. Suppose you are allowed to carry a sweet box, and the condition is that 1 kg of sweet box is allowed, including the weight of the box. So they are carrying some sweet pedas or gulab jamun or what is the favorite? Rasgullas. You know? So 1 kg total. So what is the intelligent thing? To have a light box like say 50 grams and 950 grams of sweet, or to keep a heavy box like 500 grams and 500 grams sweet, or to keep 900 gram box like old box and just little bit of sweet. What is best? Take a very light box. Or if you are intelligent, just take a plastic bag. Or just take the sweet like this. So in our family life or brahmacharya life, the other things we do in life are like the box. Maintaining the family, maintaining the body, maintaining, spending time in earning money. So that time is should be minimal. So the maximum time should be for earning the, for getting the sweet of the holy name, Krishna Katha, Vaishnav Seva, temple Seva. That should be maximized. So of course, in different cases, different. The brahmachari is like, life is like just taking in a plastic, very little. And then, but we should be careful that we have the appropriate box. And as our age increases, we reduce the weight of the box, increase the weight of. Should have a, like in the material world, people form statistics, you know, charts they prepare, HR department, how much time spent for what. So we should also think the 24 hours, how much for Krishna directly. Now you may say, Prabhuji, my body is Krishna's property and I am working, that is also for Krishna. So I will do more service, 18 hours, you know. No, it's not like that. Although every service is related to Krishna, certain services are direct devotional service, like chanting, reading Bhagavatam, doing deity worship. These are most essential things. Among all them, chanting is the most important and hearing. So we should make a schedule in such a way that we can hear and chant. Because as you become old, once you cross 60, 70, then it becomes easy to, it becomes difficult to even hear. You know, after the age of 80, you start, you have to use some instruments for hearing. Nowadays, even earlier, even chanting becomes difficult. So now we should develop the habit so that when you become old, then naturally we are hearing chanting. It becomes very natural for us. Ante Narayana Smriti, the ultimate perfection is thinking of Krishna at the time of death. Bhajan kare, sadhan kare, marti janvi. Yes, perfect Bengali. And whatever bhajan, sadhan you have done at the time of death, whatever coaching or education we have given to our children in the time of 10th standard, right? 10th standard is an important for the, what is, which class you are in? 7th. So you still have years, you know. 10th standard. 10th standard is important because that's the time, that's the grade which counts. The same way for us, death is 10th standard. It depends on, decides our future college. But the problem is that date is not announced. You know, and you cannot appear again and again. You know. So that's why this. So I will just fast forward. Lord Chaitanya is saying that I am a Mali, I have got these fruits. How many fruits shall I distribute? So I'm requesting your help. Please come and help me distribute. I order everybody in the universe, please come. And this sweet fruit of love of God is tasted by Lord Chaitanya and also distributed. In other avatars, Lord is only tasting, he is not distributing. Lord Krishna is dancing with the gopis and eating the butter of Yashoda Mai, but he is not making fresh recruitment. You don't find any asura coming and then he becomes a coward boy. The asura comes in the form of coward boy, Krishna will kill him. There is no new recruitment in Krishna Leela or Ram Leela. You don't find that Lord Ram going to Lanka and making a asura into a monkey, you know, joining the temple or something. But here in Gaur Leela, we find so many jagais, madais are delivered. And Gaur Leela is continuing. Presently, this ISKCON movement is continuation of Lord Chaitanya's mission. And there are many jagais, madais, like myself, who are getting the mercy. Prabhupada actually told that in Kali Yuga, everyone is more or less jagai, madai. If you feel that you are very qualified, then you are super jagai, madai. You should think that. And also, even if you don't feel like Jagai Madhai, you should pray I am Jagai Madhai. Because then there is more chance. Like when you want a scholarship from your college or school, they will ask what is your income, what is your father's income. So we have to present it minimal. You know? I am not saying you have to speak lies, but present in such a way that minimal. So same way you have to go to Krishna, Jagannath every day in your home, your Gornitha deities or Jagannath deities. In your home there is Jagannath and Panchatattva. No? And Gopinath Prant, who has got Jagannath, Varaha Jagannath. So, go before the deities every day and say, I'm very fallen, I'm very degraded. Please, please, you should cry. Not, sometimes it's not good, even if you feel to cry in the temple, because people will misunderstand you. But if you are home deities, then you can cry. And definitely Krishna will answer. And then finally, Lord Chaitanya concludes by saying, Bharat Bhumite Haile Manushya Janma Sar. Janma Sarthaka Kari Kara, he has taken birth in India. It is most of the devotees here. It's a duty to do Paropkar. How? Kaya, by life, Prana Artha Dhiya Vacha. Prana means giving whole life. I mean, like somebody like Brahmachari or Sannyasi gives his whole life. Then other is Artha. Artha means giving money. Obviously, this temple or any ISKCON temple needs funds. So, according to our capacity, we should try to give. And dhiya means intelligence, to give lecture, to understand the lecture, we need intelligence. And vacha means speech, by singing nicely or by glorifying Krishna, that is vacha. So by thoughts, words and deed, one must do what is beneficial for others. The example is given of a tree. What does the tree do? Whatever is best, the tree will offer to others. Nice fruits, take it. Nice flowers, take it. Doesn't keep anything for oneself. And the fruit of love of God is so delicious that one who relishes it, he wants to distribute it. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sees the people who are, anybody who eats it, he becomes maddened and he starts chanting and dancing and laughing and enjoying. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sees that people are chanting, dancing, some of them are rolling on the floor and chanting, Hari, 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 Hari. Hari 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 Hari. You seem very tired. What is the problem? Hari 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 Hari. Then Lord Chaitanya sees everyone chanting Hari Hari, then he smiles with great pleasure and he feels, yes, my coming is successful. Now I'll conclude with the morning verse. In the morning, some of you were not there, so I'm repeating. We discussed about the importance of Trinadapi Sunichyam. And we ended in the verse where Lord Chaitanya says, I raise my arms and declare that this verse should be tied around the neck like a kanti mala. And what is that verse? Trinadapi Sunichyena Tarorapi Saishna. Now I will tell you one or two pastimes in Gaurlila. There's one Brahman whose name was Vasudev. He came to meet Lord Chaitanya in Kurma Kshetra. Lord Chaitanya came to Kurma Kshetra to the house of Kurma Brahman. The Brahman's name was Kurma, the village was Kurma, and the name of the deity was Kurma. Kurma@kurma.kurma. Very easy to remember. So Lord Chaitanya came and the Brahman was so happy. He took water and washed the feet of the Lord, sprinkled the water on his family members. Then he told, today my birth, my family, my home, everything had become purified. I'm so happy. And now, I want to travel with you. I am tired of these miseries of family life. Now you may think, Lord Chaitanya will say, okay, come. Yes, sit on the back seat. We are going together. Lord Chaitanya said, don't speak like this. I want you to preach in family life. Jare dekho, tare kaho, Krishna pradesh. This instruction was given to a grahastha devotee, the Kurma Brahman, in the holy place known as Sri Kurma. Near Srikakulam station, 8 kilometers from there. So when Lord Chaitanya left, and then Vasudev came. Oh, where is Lord Chaitanya? Where is Lord Gauranga? When somebody cries for Gauranga, he gets Gauranga. And this Brahman, he was suffering from leprosy, very severe disease. There were some worms around his whole body. He was so compassionate and broad-minded that when a worm would fall down, he would pick up the worm and put inside. This worm also had the right. His body is not mine, it's Krishna's property. It's like sometimes in train you have RAC, you know. There are two people share the seat. This is RAC, the whole body. And then he asked everybody, where is Lord Chaitanya? Lord Chaitanya already left. So as he was crying, Lord Chaitanya came back. It's the only story in the entire Chaitanya Charitamrita where Lord Chaitanya took a U-turn just to meet one devotee. And when Lord Chaitanya came, this Brahman was so happy. He came near Lord Chaitanya and Lord Chaitanya embraced him. This Brahmana was surprised. His body became not only wormless, but it became golden in complexion. But the Brahmana said, Kvaham daridra papiyan, kva Krishna Sri Niketana. Where am I, a poor, sinful Brahmana, a friend of the Brahmana? I cannot call myself Brahmana. And where is Krishna? Sri Niketan. He is the Lord of Lakshmi Devi. And still he embraced me. That means the Supreme Lord. This verse was spoken by Sudama. You know, when Krishna embraced Sudama in Dwaraka, Sudama went on the request of his wife to get some service to the Lord. And then the Vasudev said, my Lord, I am distressed. Huh? Why are you distressed? You are cured. He said, you know, so far people were just avoiding me. Nobody would like to sit next to a person who is having worms while eating prasadam, you know. Nobody would like to go near to smell that bad odor. And because of that, I was feeling myself very humble. Neglected but humbled. But now everybody will say, oh, you are Vasudev. Oh, Lord embraced. We saw in WhatsApp your message. Lord embraced you. And because of that, I will be proud. And pride is a greater danger disease than leprosy or cancer or any disease. So now, how will I remain humble? And Lord Chaitanya told him a secret. He said, I will tell you a secret. Nirantara tumi lav Krishna naam. You chant the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. And Prabhupada says in the 7th canto, without being humble and meek, one cannot make spiritual advancement. A devotee who is humble, he will not get disturbed. But if you are proud, then you may get disturbed. This is the last lecture of today's discussion, the Gaur Purnima lecture, given by Srila Prabhupada in the year 1976 in Mayapur Dham. Prabhupada is saying So our process is to submit, to become humble. Unless you become humble or submit, there is no hope of advancing. And then he quotes this famous verse. Trinadapi Sanichena Tarurapis. If you want to chant Hare Krishna, keep this verse in mind. Prabhupada says, grass is lying on the street, it never protests. In the lawn, people come, some of them may even trample upon the grass or spit on the grass. The second is Tarora. The tree is giving so much help. Fruits, flowers, leaves, whatever it has. And people come to cut the tree. The tree is giving the protection to those who are cutting him. The tree is not saying, I have given you so much help and now you are cutting me. Sometimes it happens, you know, we do service to somebody and that devotee sometimes becomes inimical to us. That becomes very sour feelings. We should not do this to others, but if somebody does this to us, we should accept it. And last point, Prabhupada says, Amanina Manadena. For oneself, one should not expect any respect, but all respects for us. So I have a question in this concluding talk. Why should I respect somebody who is junior to me and younger to me and less qualified in spiritual life or material life? I know I should honor senior devotees. I can honor equal devotees. But somebody who is just a new devotee, is not even following the regulative principles properly. So how can I honor and respect him? Anybody would like to answer this question? Krishna? Krishna is inspiring him. Yes. Perfect answer. That shows that you are reading Prabhupada's books nicely. Krishna Adhishtane Sarve Jive Jani. There's a song by Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Shri Krishna Kirtane Jabe Manas Tohar Paramayatana Tahe Labe Adhikar. That my dear friend, if you want to chant the name of Krishna constantly, you should do it in this way. Krishna Adhishtane Sarve Jive Jani Jadi. Knowing Krishna to be residing in everybody's heart. I may not like this animal, bird or human, but Krishna in the heart of the Brahma, of the ant also. So I must respect. Whenever you offer respects, ultimately it goes to Paramatma. So we can respect everyone. And in this mood we can chant. So let us end with a small prayer that we may follow this divine teachings of Prabhupada as given to us in this book. And we can chant pure holy name to whatever degree possible and distribute the same to whomever we meet.